Hey everybody, it's good to be with you, Richard, and I'm back with you again. Yeah, it's me again. All right, we're not going to be talking about my Panzer anymore. I know, it's a clone and there's a voltage drop in it and all. Okay, fine. Let's get on to something new for a change. We're going to be talking about two things today. One is an original mechanical mod from the land of meatballs and spaghetti, and the other one, this is about battery safety and something terrible happened yesterday. It was a public holiday in Malaysia, so I decided to take my wife and my kid for a movie, you know, since it's a holiday, and I decided to take my kid out for Rio 2. So we had a great time, came out, the cinema was in a shopping mall, and we started to walk around. I was walking and suddenly I felt this heat building up in my right pocket, and I had my mechanical mod on my left pocket. Big mistake, I took a spare battery along, 18350. The mistake is not carrying the spare battery along, but not having it in a plastic container like this. You know, these casings, yeah? This one is quite nice, Vape Monster. And that's the big mistake. I just carried the 18350 in my pocket together with my car keys, and in my car, on my car keys, there was this screwdriver attached to it. So I think you know the rest of the deal. And what happened was it must have touched the contacts. It created a shot and it started to heat up. It started to burn up. Thank goodness my pants didn't catch on fire. Worse, didn't explode and, you know, lose a leg or something like that. And I had to really do it fast. It was just so hot. I didn't care. I had to put my hands in there and just pull the whole thing out. And everything just fell on the ground. And after that, I saw the whole entire section, not this battery. I threw that away. I got rid of it. The whole entire section actually just got burnt up, you know, very badly. And like, even the keychain, it's got pieces of plastic because I had just bought a small little item which was in a plastic bag in my pocket. And you see all this plastic melted, you know, on the keychain as well. You see, it's still stuck to it. So there you go. As much as we emphasize about battery safety all the time, vaping on sub-ohms, make sure you're using a high drain battery and things like that. Just the simplest thing, I was so callous. Shame on me, actually. I forgot to put this in a plastic box. So the next time, you know, it doesn't matter if it's a single battery or even if you want to carry just one or two batteries, make sure they're in all these little boxes and just keep them in your pocket. The problem is because I thought they was going to be so bulky, I said, forget it, just a single battery. What's a big issue? And put it in my pocket and that's it. That happened. So be very careful. Besides vaping, you also have to think about how we, you know, transport these batteries in our pockets, because they can actually cause a shot and catch on fire, at worst explode, you know, things like that. I don't know. And there are lots and lots of videos actually, and even tutorials on the internet and all that on YouTube, where you can learn about battery safety. So please be very careful. All right, vape safe. All right, time to move on. Before we move on, let me take another vape again. Despite the voltage drop because of the coating on the Black Hawk Panzer, still not too bad actually. Kind of like it. Especially for the way it looks, you know. Matches my shirt, matches my hat, my cap and all that. So there you go. And yes, today we're going to be talking about an original mechanical mod for a change. You know, I've done a couple of clones here and there, and before anybody decides to nickname me Clone King, I thought I better do an original mechanical mod. And I just got this a couple of days back. This is the version 2 of the Atomo by Gille, if that's how you say it, from Italy. All right, so this is made in Italy, the version 2. It is really, really shiny, and this is definitely going to be a fingerprint magnet, you know, but sad to say I'm a sucker for all these shiny things, you know. They have a few versions of it. They have the brushed stainless steel, they have the fully polished stainless steel, In fact, they have about 4 different other versions, just like the Nemesis. They got all these different combinations. Mine comes with brass accents on the top cap and also here in the firing switch as well. They've made a couple of changes to this version compared to the version 1, the previous version, the first original Atomo. And I got this just about 2 or 3 days back probably, and all it came is in this little plastic bag here. Okay, so this is in 18350 mode, guys, and wrapped up in this little polystyrene wrapper, and comes with, you see, wrapped up like that. If you remove it, this is your 18490 or 18500 battery tube with the logo engraved on it. Okay, stainless steel, marine grade stainless steel. And that's about it. No spare oil rings, no spare parts, no free tiny little screwdrivers. And this authenticity card from Le Gadgets, the place that I bought. Something that I really like about these guys is they've come up with their own authenticity card where they print out their company name, the logo, and the model number that you've bought, and when did you buy, the serial number, which is 370, that's my serial number. And then they've got a authenticity seal here, sticker, right? And this, all these details are actually on their website at legadgets.com, and so that you can verify that you have actually purchased an original authentic Atomo or any other mechanical mod that they sell. They only sell originals apparently. So this is the version. This is the 18350 mode with the laser etched logo on it together with Atomo. Just taking a look, quick look, brief look. That's the other atomic logo at the bottom. That's the top cap there, your brass top cap. Okay. Alright, this is actually a natural progression from the previous version 1. Like I said, I got this from Le Gadgets for 640 ringgit. Doing the conversion is equivalent to about 198 US dollars. They have evolved from the previous version. What Atomo did was got feedback from the customers on how they can improve the Atomo. And a customer says, maybe you can look on the safety side of things, the looks, improve the looks, portability perhaps. And they actually took all their feedback into consideration and did the improvements. So what they added, which the version 1 don't have, is a locking ring. They now have a locking ring so that it will prevent misfires once you lock it. And once you've locked it, you can just put it in your pocket and carry it around, all right? Previously, they didn't have the locking ring, so if they don't have the locking ring, it might actually cause a misfire. But still, this is insight. This seems to be the latest trend these days to have recessed firing switches, which I think is a brilliant idea, because if you put it down on the tabletop, it doesn't fire. So you don't have to keep unlocking and locking and unlocking and unlocking. So this is perfect. And because they had to deal with the firing switch, what they had to do was reduce the diameter of the firing switch, but increased the thickness of the walls of the firing switch. Okay, this is to prevent what they call ovalization. In case you accidentally drop the mechanical mod, the firing switch will not run out of shape, gets distorted, and you'll probably have to replace the firing switch. So to prevent that, they thickened the walls slightly, all right, and decreased on the firing switch so that they could put in the locking ring. So hope that makes sense to you. All right, the laser engraved logo that they have here, the Atomic logo, and the Atomo here, and here, all the logos and including their serial number, which is right at the bottom. Hopefully you can see. It's 370, yeah? Apparently they have enhanced it to make sure it lasts, because the previous version, probably, after using for a while, it sort of like fades off and things like that. So they have improved on that. And yeah, this is marine grade stainless steel. They come in 18350 and 18490 or 18500 tube here, just one tube. If you want to do the 18650 battery tube, you'll probably have to purchase it separately, alright? I'm going to do an up-close for your benefit, just to get a closer look at it. Feast your eyes on the original Atomo V2, and I'll catch you later on a different camera angle. Stay with us. So there you have, ladies and gentlemen, the Atomo V2 by Gille, that's made in Italy. Once again, I bought this for 640 ringgit at Le Gadgets, and here we have them up close. I'm going to pick it up and let you have a really closer look at it. And we have the two tubes there. One is the 18490, 18500 battery tube, which is this one that I have here. I'm going to bring it up to you to have a closer look at it. And there you have the engraving of the logo right here, the atomic logo, and the words Atomo here, which they've enhanced on the what they call laser edging to make it last longer. I take it the previous version fades off or something like that. And you have your battery vents here in case your battery gets hot and it needs to vent. There you have all the battery vents all around. I think there are altogether four holes there, and it's made of marine grade stainless steel. You have your beautiful threadings in there, which looks pretty good, and the entire tube here for your 18500 or 18490 battery. All right, so that's your battery tube there, and now we're going to pick up the 18350 together with the firing switch and the top cap. This is how your entire mechanical mod looks. It's pretty nice. It comes with a brass accent on my model here. They have a few other versions, as I mentioned earlier on. And there you have your firing switch at the bottom with the atomic logo. Okay, pretty nice. And again, we have the same logo laser etched here. If I bring it closer to have a look, yep, that's how it looks. Sorry about the focusing, guys. As soon as I can get some good focusing here. Oops, come on. Thank you. Yep, that's how it looks. Very shiny. And the finishing is absolutely beautiful. Yeah, you can see the finishing here. It's beautiful. Focus. Thank you. And you have your top cap here with the air channels on each corner here, each side, and you have your contact pin, which I think it's stainless steel or brass. We'll have to check that out. Right now the top is polished brass as well. Yeah. Focus, please. Thank you. Alright, so your vent holes just the same. And you have your firing switch here. This is the locking ring. Couple of turns to lock it. Once it's locked, looks like this, and you can't fire it. And to unlock, anti-clockwise, and the firing is nice and soft and springy. Okay, this is not using a spring, ladies and gentlemen. They have used a magnet for the firing switch. Alright, so we're going to take a closer look. We're going to open this up. The threading is quite nice, as you can see, smooth. That's the threading in there, and that is your firing switch. Alright, it has got a Delrin, black Delrin here. The contacts are made of brass,
This is stainless steel. Okay. And remove it. All you got to do is just turn this, grab this pin here, and turn it. Okay. Turn it. Oops, there you go. It's a brass contact pin here. Yep. We'll lay that down. There you go. You see the magnets? Yep. That's how it looks inside. Yeah. It's a little bit dirty. Alright. This is how your magnet works. You've got two magnets. Okay. So you put one into this. Okay, once it sits proper, you take this one to oppose it. Let's see if it opposes. Yeah. Ooh. Sorry about that. A bit off camera there. Pick up a top cap. And you just put it in here. Right? There's a little groove there for it to sit in. Take this, push it in. Oops, sorry, I think I got the wrong side. Now I gotta pull it out. Sorry about that. So we gotta do it all over again. Take this out. Come on. Let me put this down. It's a little bit. The magnets are really strong. Okay. It should be this way. Alright. So this goes in here once again. And this goes. Okay, this goes in here. Alright, put this down. This goes in here, back into the groove. Alright, and this should go in here. Yep, so you can feel the spring now. It's opposing. And take that little firing pin. Put it back. It's a little bit hard to work trying to get it in frame and trying to have to look at the screw. Okay, got it. Turn it. Tighten it a little bit. Okay, it's all set. Okay, there you go. We're going to put an 18350 battery in there. And we're going to come back and see how she vapes. Alright, the positive side in first. That's an AWIMR battery. And we screw on this bottom cap. Oop. There you go. Lock it. Yep. That's your 18350. This is a 22 millimeter diameter mechanical mod. Alright. I'm going to try and get an atomizer. My K-Fun. With my customized top cap and also a brown drip tip. So, doesn't sit flush. What you got to do is open it. Oh, by the way, I forgot to show you the top cap. Good thing I brought the atomizer. So that's your contact pin there. It's a brass contact pin, and it's like a Chiyu style contact pin, where you have also a black dowel ring. The inside, you see this other pin in here? Alright, focus. Yep, there are two pins there. Okay, so you grab the inside pin, loosen it. There you go, now you see it clearly. Alright, so just push this down flush. The pin goes in, you extend this, and once it's extended, you can now screw this back in. There you go. It looks absolutely great with the K-Fun. That's your mod. The Atomo logo, yep. Alright, when we come back, we will see how she vapes. Alright, stay with us.
Alright guys, so you just saw our Atomo by Gille version 2 up close there. Really close look there, and checked out all the parts, and here I have it on my K-Fun Light Plus with a customized top cap and also my Atomo Mikani drip tip. So we've got a whole entire setup that's original now. And yep, it looks really good. Yeah, we're gonna see how she vapes right now. Let me just unlock it. So now you have the locking ring to deal with. Oh, I just locked it, sorry. Wow. Well, the Atomo, what do you call, mechanical mod has been known to be, you know, hit pretty hard. Something like the Nemesis as well. Wow. I've got a 1.1 microcoil in here with cotton and my favorite juice, which is a raw mango, which is quite popular here in Malaysia. Nice, I like the way it hits. It's a hard hitter, all right. Apparently, though, I did a voltage test and I also checked it on the internet with other reviewers as well. There's, I think, one of the other reviewer who says there's a 0.4 drop in voltage. I did my own voltage test earlier on with this, my voltage meter, and I recorded a 0.3, between 0.3 and 0.4 voltage drop. But yet, you know, when I vape on it, it hits really hard. You get a really nice warm vape, and at the same time it's, you know, got the power. I've got a fresh 18350 battery inside. You see what I mean? Nice. It's a really nice, sorry about the vapor. It's a really nice vape, and I like the feel of the button, nice and soft. And I could just place it on any tabletop and it won't fall and it won't miss fire. And I don't have to lock the ring again until I want to carry it around and put it in my pocket. Let's take one more vape before I call it a day. Beautiful, nice, really like it. And one thing about original mechanical mods, it's true, you know. I mean, look at the finishing. It's absolutely perfect, you know, in comparison to a mod. But then again, you know, to be able to always afford an original, I'm afraid I'm not going to be able to do that. Off and on, I do buy my original mechanical mods or my DNA 30s. In fact, I got another DNA 30 coming in, so watch out for that review coming up soon. Until I talk to you again, vape safe, and remember, if you're carrying your batteries around, make sure you have it in a safe plastic container, you know? Always vape safe and take care.